So, student, welcome in this lecture. So, as per the sequence of the yesterday's lecture, today we are going to study the structure of the ovule. Okay, so see the structure of ovule. Okay, structure of ovule. Student, this ovule, it is also called as megasporangium. Okay, it is also called as the megasporangium. That means, what is the megasporangium? It is a megaspore bearing structure. Okay, it is a megasporangium. So see, as per your syllabus, we are going to study the structure of anatropous ovule. Structure of anatropous ovule. Or we have to study the LS of anatropous ovule. LS of anatropous ovule. So we have to study here the LS of anatropous ovule. So what is that? The anatropous ovule. Okay, anatropous ovule. Remember, the anatropous ana means it is inverted. Okay, ana means inverted, and tropos means axis. So remember, student, in this the anatropous ovule, the axis of that ovule is inverted. Okay, axis of that ovule, it is inverted. That means the axis of the anatropous ovule, they bend all along the length of the funicle. All along the length of funicle. So what is that axis? The one type of ovule, that ovule, it is an ortho. Orthotropous ovule. Okay, one type of ovule, it is an orthotropous ovule. In that orthotropous ovule, the ortho, okay, ortho means straight. Okay, ortho means straight. And here the tropos means here the axis. Okay, tropos means here the axis. So in this ovule, see, so suppose this is the orthotropous ovule. Okay, this is the orthotropous ovule, see, student. And in this orthotropous ovule, okay, in this the orthotropous ovule, this is the three main parts of the ovule. That is, this is the micropyle. Okay, this is the chalaza. Okay, chalaza, and this is the funicle of the ovule. Okay, funicle of the ovule. So in this orthotropous ovule, it is not included in your syllabus, but for your understanding, what is meant by the anatropous ovule. So for that, we have to learn first what is mean by the orthotropous ovule. Okay, so see, in this orthotropous ovule, the micropyle, chalaza, and the funicle, these are the three main parts of ovule. These three main parts of ovule, student, they are present on the same vertical line. Okay, so they are present on the same vertical line, in the sense this is the axis. Okay, this is the axis of the ovule. Okay, this is the axis of ovule. See, in case of anatropous ovule, this chalaza and micropyle, they bend downward. Okay, they bend downward. Okay, so how that anatropous ovule look like? So this is the structure of the anatropous ovule. We have to show diagrammatically. So see, in these parts, so this is the micropyle. So this is the micropyle portion. Then this portion, it is a chalaza portion. Okay, student, this is the chalaza portion, and as usual, this is the funiculus. Okay, or this is the funicle. Okay, this is the funicle. So see, in this case, in this the anatropous ovule, how it is inverted, because the micropyle and chalaza, they never present on the same vertical straight line. This micropyle, they bend downward in this the Anatropos ovule. So because of this, the micropyle and the chalaza, they only present on the same vertical line, and the funicle, they never present on that. Okay, funicle, they never present on that. So clearly, student, when you compare this ovule, means this Anatropos ovule, with this Orthotropos ovule, this Anatropos ovule, it is clearly inverted. So because of this inverted position of ovule, the micropyle and chalaza, they present on the same vertical line, and the, so because of this, the micropyle, they come closer with the funicle. So remember, such a type of ovule, it is called as the Anatropos ovule. Yes, have you understand this? I think you understand well what is meant by the Anatropos ovule and how the axis of ovule, it is inverted. So now, student, we are going to study the detailed structure of the Anatropos ovule as per your syllabus. Okay, so see, with the help of the diagram, okay, with the help of the suitable diagram, we have to study the structure of Anatropos ovule. So let's see the structure of Anatropos ovule, student. You see how we have to draw the sketch of the Anatropos ovule. You draw with me the sketch of the Anatropos ovule. So example, the Anatropos ovule. Okay, Anatropos ovule. So, you draw with me the structure of Anatropos ovule. You have to draw first the centrally placed nucellus. Okay, centrally placed nucellus, and it is followed by the integuments. Okay, student, how we can draw the structure of ovule very nicely or very carefully. You see, so this is a very simple diagram, the structure of Anatropos ovule. So see how it is drawn. It shows the centrally placed female gametophyte. Okay. So this is the structure of Anatropos ovule. Okay, in this, student, in this, the three main parts of ovule, this is the micropyle. Okay, this is the micropyle. Then another part, it is, this is the chalaza. Okay, this is chalaza. Okay, this is the chalaza. So this is the second part we have to say. And this is the next one, it is the funicle. Okay, funicle of the ovule. So see, student, in this Anatropos ovule only, the micropyle and chalaza, they present on the same straight line, and the funicle, they never present on that line. So because of a inversion or inverted position of this ovule, the micropyle, they come closer with the funicle. So see, this structure of the Anatropos ovule. So we are just drawn the structure of Anatropos ovule, or we are to say the LS. Okay, LS, longitudinal section of the Anatropos ovule. So this ovule, student, this ovule, they are having the two main parts. So what are the two main parts? So ovule, they are having the two parts. Okay, they are having the two parts. The first part is the stalk of the ovule, and the second part is the body of the ovule. So the stalk and body, these are the two main parts of ovule. So what is the stalk? The stalk of the ovule, it is called as a funicle. Okay, it is called as a funicle. Then this funicle, they are attached toward this side. Okay, toward this side, they are attached here. Okay, they are attached here with the placenta. Okay, they are attached toward the lower side to the placenta. And you know that, student, the placenta, where they are attached, the placenta, they are attached to the ovary wall or the axis of the ovary. And then from the placenta, the funicle is developed. And the funicle, they are attached to the body of ovule. Means this is the point of contact. Okay, this is the point of contact. And this point of contact is called as the hilum. Okay, this is the hilum. So this funicle, they are attached to the body of ovule. That point of contact, it is called as a funicle. And this funicle, so remember, this another part of ovule, it is called as a body. Okay, so this much part, it is called as a body. So this is the body of ovule. Remember, this body of ovule, they bend over the entire length of the funicle. Okay, they bend downward. So like this way, suppose this is the orthotropous ovule, and this orthotropous ovule, they bend downward like this way. Okay, and so this is the funicle and this is the ovule. So all along the length of funicle, this ovule, they bend downward. Okay, they bend downward. So because of a system of the bending of ovule, or when the body of ovule is bent downward, what happened? The entire funicle, they form the ridge-like structure over the body of ovule, and that ridge-like structure, it is seen, it is called as the raphe. Okay, that ridge-like structure, it is called as the raphe. So the raphe, it is developed. Then the next one, the body of ovule. See, what is the body of ovule? The body of ovule, it is made up of the two main parts. The two main parts, the centrally placed nucellus. Okay, centrally placed nucellus. Student, this nucellus, it is called as the megasporangium proper. Okay, it is a megasporangium proper. So I want to mention in short, it is called as the megasporangium proper. Okay, this is the megasporangium proper. And the another part of the body of ovule, so say this is the first part and this is the second part, these are the integuments. Okay, these are the integuments. So this body of ovule, they are having the two parts. The first one, it is the nucellus. So this is the entire nucellus, student. Okay, this is the entire nucellus. So at this moment, you don't consider this centrally placed mass. So this portion, it is the nucellus. Okay, this portion, it is the nucellus. So this the nucellus, it is the central part of the ovule. What is the nucellus, student? The nucellus means it is made up of the thin walled, compactly arranged mass of cell. That mass of the parenchymatous cell, it is called as a nucellus. Okay, it is called as a nucellus. And the another part of the body, it is the integument. So around the nucellus, the integuments are developed. Okay, around the nucellus, integuments are developed. So remember, the who take part in the development of integument, the base of nucellus, okay, this is the base of nucellus. This base of nucellus, it is called as a chalaza. Okay, it is called as a chalaza. This chalaza, they take part in the development of integuments. Okay, they take part in the development of integuments. And from these, the two integuments are developed. Okay, two integuments are developed. See, this is the outer, okay, outer integument. okay, this is the outer integument, and student, this is the inner, okay, inner integument. Okay, this is the inner integument. So outer and inner integument, it is formed from the chalasa. Let's see, this outer and inner integument, these are the protective covering of the central plus nucellus. But see, this outer and inner integument, this outer integument, it is slightly larger, or it is a longer, we have to say, longer than that of the outer integument. So the inner integument, they take part in the formation of micropylar opening. Okay, micropylar opening. So in this ovule, student, the micropylar opening, it is exactly opposite to the chalaza of the ovule. It is exactly opposite to the chalaza of the ovule. So this inner integument, always remember, as far as the NCERT point of view is concerned, or the CET level is concerned, who forms the micropylar opening, or which integument take part in the formation of micropylar opening? The inner integument take part in the formation of micropylar opening, and because of that, the inner integument, they are slightly longer than that of the outer integument, and outer integument, it is shorter. Okay, so this, our integuments, these are the two protective coverings of the nucellus. They give protection to the nucellus. But what is the actual function of the integument? At the ovule stage, it gives protection to the nucellus. But after fertilization, student, this after fertilization, this integument, they take part in the formation of seed coat. Okay? Means outer integument, they take part in the formation of the testa, and testa of the seed, means outermost covering of the seed coat. Then this inner integument, they take part in the formation of the tegument. The tegument means the inner layer of seed coat, and the testa means the outer layer of seed coat. So the outer and inner layer of seed coat, it is formed from these integuments after fertilization. So you remember, student. Then this, the ovule, they are having as usual two parts, stalk and body. What is the stalk? The stalk of ovule, it is called as a funicle. So what is the function of funicle? It conducts the food material from placenta. Okay, placenta, and it transfers that food material toward the body of ovule. This is the function of the funicle. Then what is the function of chalaza? The chalaza, they take part in the development of the integument. Okay. So the integument formation, it is the function of the chalazal portion, okay, chalazal region. Then the next to that, the integument, it give protection to the central plus nucellus during ovule stage, and after fertilization, they take part in the formation of seed coat. Then what is the function of this micropyle? The micropyle, during fertilization, the micropyle, they provide the way to the pollen tube, and that pollen tube, they enter through this micropyle, and they show the movement toward this centrally blessed female gametophyte. Okay, centrally blessed female gametophyte. So this is at the maturity of nucellus. What is the function of nucellus? Nucellus at its maturity, they develop the female gametophyte at the center. So this is the centrally blessed female gametophyte. Female gametophyte, centrally placed female gametophyte. So remember, when we see toward the entire ovule, this only the female gametophyte which are developed inside the ovule, this female gametophyte, it is haploid, and the remaining structure of ovule, it is totally diploid. So remember, the remaining structure of ovule, it is a sporophytic body, or a sporophytic portion of that the ovule itself. Okay, so this is a sporophytic portion, and only the centrally placed this female gametophyte, it is haploid, and it is a gametophytic region, or it is a gametophytic portion. So it is a which gametophyte? It is a female gametophyte, and it is the haploid one. So this female gametophyte, and what is the structure of this female gametophyte, student? This is the seven-celled, okay, this is 7-celled, 8-nucleated. Okay, it is 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. Okay, 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. So how it is a 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure? So these are the, this is the egg apparatus. Okay, this is the egg apparatus. Okay, we are going to study this portion in detail later. So this is the egg apparatus. It is made up of the 3 cells. Okay, it is made up of the 3 cells. Then this is the central plus secondary nucleus. Okay, this is the centrally placed secondary nuclei. Okay, this is the secondary nuclei, or it is also called as polar nuclei. Okay, it is a polar nuclei. Then these are the 3 antipodal cells. So these are the antipodals. Okay, these are the antipodal cells. How much cells? These are the 3 cells. So see, student, how it is a 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. So this is the 3 cells from the egg apparatus, and these are the 3 cells from the antipodal. So 3 cells and these 3 cells. Okay, these 3 cells and these 3 cells. How much it is? 6 cells. And this means how much nuclei? The 6 nuclei. And this is a central place, 2 definitive nuclei. Or these are also called as polar nuclei. So in all total 8, means 3 plus 2 plus 3. How much it is? 8 nucleated structure. And how much? How it is a 7-cell structure? So these are the 3 cells, 1, 2, 3. 3 egg apparatus cell plus 3 antipodal cell, 6 cell, and this is the centrally placed cell, or this is the central cell, which are having the 2 polar nuclei. So this is the 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. Yes, have you understand this? So the embryo sac, or the female gametophyte of angiosperm, it is a clear cut, it is a 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. Yes, have you understood this? Then again, I want to remind you is that what is the structure of male gametophyte of angiosperm? What is the structure of male gametophyte of angiosperm? The pollen tube with 2 non-motile male gametes. These are the structure of the male gametophyte of angiosperm. So at this moment, student, I think you understand what is the structure of female gametophyte of angiosperm. The female gametophyte of angiosperm, it is a 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. Okay, 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. So, I think you understand well, this 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure, where this is developed? This is developed inside the nucleus of the ovule. So that, student, we have studied the structure of Anatropous ovule. So sequentially, what we are going to study next, how this female gametophyte develop inside the nucleus of the Anatropous ovule. So sequentially, what we are going to study next, the development of female gametophyte. So see, student, the development of female gametophyte inside the nucleus. So see, the development of female gametophyte, or that female gametophyte, it is also called as an embryo sac. Mulanno ithe lakshat gya ki ithe female gametophyte cha dusra naav kay? Embryo sac. So remember, student, embryo sac and female gametophyte, it is one and the same. It is 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. So we are going to study how that female gametophyte develop inside the nucleus of that ovule. Okay, see, first the few changes took place inside the nucleus of that ovule. There is a the hypodermal cell of the nucleus towards the micropylar region, they become functional, and that hypodermal cell of nucleus, it is diploid. they become functional and it acts as a archisporial cell. Okay, and that archisporial cell as well, it is a diploid. They are having the 2 and ploidy level, and then this archisporial cell, they undergo the mitotic division and they form the 2 cells. Means the one cell toward the outer side and one cell toward the inner side. So the, this is the outer cell, suppose. This is the, that outer cell, it is called as a parietal cell. Okay, parietal cell, and means that parietal cell, they are located toward the outer, toward the peripheral layer of the new cells on its micropylous side. Okay, and the inner cell, it acts as a megaspore mother cell. So we have to study the development of female gametophyte from the inner formed megaspore mother cell. Okay, so see actual situation of the megaspore mother cell inside this new cell. So this is the anatropous ovule, that ovule we have studied before. So this is anatropous ovule, and this is the functional megaspore mother cell which is diploid. Okay, which is diploid. That functional megaspore mother cell, they divide by a one first meiotic division. Okay, meiotic division. So student, you remember this meiotic division. Meiotic division, it is a reductional division. So first meiotic division takes place inside the megaspore mother cell which is diploid, and there is a formation of the vertical row of the tetrad. Means the megaspore, they are arranged vertically. Okay, they are arranged vertically. So all four haploid megaspores, they are arranged vertically. So it is called as a vertical tetrad of megaspore, and all the megaspores are haploid. Yes, have you understood this? All the megaspores, they are haploid. Then see in the next what happened. The these three megaspore which are present toward this micropylous side. Okay, micropylar side, that three megaspore, haploid megaspore, they degenerate. Okay, they degenerate, and only toward the inner side, means toward the chalazal side. Okay, toward the, this chalazal side, toward the chalazal side, means this megaspore, they become functional, and it is called as chalazal functional megaspore. So student, this is the chalazal functional megaspore. So the further development takes place inside this chalazal functional megaspore. So remember, I want to use the one term from the diploid megaspore mother cell up to the formation of the functional haploid. Okay, functional haploid chalazal megaspore, it is called as the megasporogenesis. Okay, just like we are studying in case of the male reproductive organ, microsporogenesis. So here, the formation of megaspore from the megaspore mother cell through reductional division, it is called as a megasporogenesis. So these are the events takes place in the megasporogenesis. Then from this megasporogenesis, what happened? There is a next step, the megagametogenesis. Okay, megagametogenesis. So this further megagametogenesis, it is takes place inside the chalazal functional megaspore. So this is the chalazal functional megaspore. So the functional megaspore which are haploid, and they are present on the chalazal side of this the new cells. Okay, chalazal side of the new cells. Then what happened inside the chalazal functional megaspore? Three successive free nuclear division takes place. So the first free nuclear division, what is it mean by the free nuclear division, student? The free nuclear division means there is a division of nucleus, but there is no division of the cell cytosol. Manje free nuclear division mare nucleus divide hoto pan cell cytoplasm divide hot nahi, phakt nucleus cha number ha vadat jato. And cell cytoplasm is the same. okay. So the, in the first free nuclear division, there is a formation of two nuclei. मुझे एक का पसुन दो nucleus है. Okay, this is the mitotic division. Then in the second free nuclear division, this two nuclei it is from this two there is a four nuclei are formed. Okay, four nuclei are formed. And then in the third free nuclear division, means after the third free nuclear division, from the four free nuclei, there is a formation of the eight free nuclei. Okay, so these are the four towards the chalazal side and these four towards the micropylar side. Then what happened? From the four nuclei, from this micropylar side, the one nuclei they move towards the center. म्हणून इथे आपण छोटासा एरो दाखवलेला आहे की हा न्यूक्लियस ह्या सेंटर कडे मूव होतो. हाच मूव होतो असं नाहीये. ज्या चार न्यूक्लियाय मायक्रोपायलर रिजन कडे आहेत त्याच्यापैकी कुठल्या तरी एक, पण आपण इथे फिगर मध्ये सोयीचं व्हावं म्हणून आपण या न्यूक्लियस पासून सेंटर कडे छोटासा एरो दाखवलेला आहे. म्हणजे मायक्रोपायलर रिजन चार चार न्यूक्लियस पैकी एक न्यूक्लियस हा सेंटर कडे मूव होतो. तसंच चालाजल रिजनच्या चार न्यूक्लियस पैकी एक न्यूक्लियस सेंट्रल कडे मूव होतो. ओके, म्हणजे स्ट्रक्चर कसं झालं, मायक्रोपायलर रिजनला तीन न्यूक्लियर राहतील, चालाजल रिजनला तीन न्यूक्लियर राहतील आणि सेंटर कडे दोन न्यूक्लियर येतील. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दीस न्यूक्लियाय शोज द अरेंजमेंट ऍट लास्ट. हाऊ दे शोज द अरेंजमेंट, three nuclei toward the micropylar side, three nuclei toward the chalazal side and two nuclei present toward the center. So 3 plus 2 plus 3 arrangement show arrangement of nuclei. They shows the final organization and what they form, they form the embryo sac, or it is also called as a female gametophyte. So this is the final structure of female gametophyte. Yes, have you understand, student, how the female gametophyte or embryo sac, they are developed inside the nucleus of the ovule. Okay, so this is one, the seven celled eight nucleated, okay, seven celled eight nucleated structure developed inside the nucleus of the ovule. So you remember, student. Then I will show you the one more characteristic feature. But before that, you remember, from the functional megaspore, from the functional haploid megaspore up to the formation of seven celled eight nucleated embryo sac, it is called as the megagametogenesis. Okay, it is called as the megagametogenesis. So remember, such a type of the female gametophyte, the endospore, this such type of the female gametophyte development, we are to explain with the help of the two words. The first one, such a type of development, it is called as a monosporic development of the embryo sac. Okay, monosporic. Why it is a monosporic? Because the development of female gametophyte, it is takes place inside the single chalazal functional megaspore. So the name is given monosporic embryo sac development. Then another word it is used with respect to this development, it is the endosporous development. What is the endosporous? Endosporous, endo means inside, and sporous means spore, inside the spore. So all development of the female gametophyte, it is takes place inside the chalazal functional megaspore. So that type of the development, it is called as the endosporic development of the female gametophyte. So you remember these one. Now, student, in brief, I want to show you this seven-celled, eight-nucleated structure of embryo sac. The synergy shows the fiber-like structure. Okay, synergy shows the fiber-like structure over that. And what is that fiber-like structure developed over the that synergy? Okay, fiber-like structure developed over that synergy. That structure, it is called as a filiform apparatus. Suppose this is the egg. Okay, this is the egg cell, and these are the laterally placed synergids. Okay, these are the laterally placed synergids. So suppose I want to magnify this synergid. Okay, this is the egg cell as well, and these are the two laterally placed synergids. I want to magnify this single synergid cell. Okay, this is the synergid cell. So over that synergid cell, the finger-like position, just like this finger, how that finger it is developed from this point. So the finger-like projection it is developed. Okay, so step of the finger-like projection it is developed over the synergid. Okay, sorry, over the synergid, that finger-like projection it is called as a filiform apparatus. Okay, these are the filiform apparatus. So remember, I will tell you here at this moment, what is the function of filiform apparatus? The filiform apparatus, they provide the way for the growing pollen tube, or they direct the growth of pollen tube during fertilization. So suppose this is a coming pollen tube, and this pollen tube, they mostly enter inside the filiform apparatus, and then they move further. So this part we are going to study while studying the process of fertilization. So student, we are studying in detail how the female gametophyte develop inside the new cells, or that new cell is, it is also called as a megasporangium proper. So student, at this moment we have the two the respective the gametophytes. On one side we have the male gametophyte, which is having the pollen tube with two non-motile male gametes, and just now we have studied the structure of the female gametophyte, means it is a 7-celled, 8-nucleated structure. So we have the male gametophyte and we have the female gametophyte. So automatically, what is the next sequential event in the sexual reproduction of higher plant? That event will be the fertilization. Okay, fertilization. But before that, as per your syllabus, in next video we are going to study the pollination mechanism, how it is takes place in higher plant. So with this student, now we will stop at this moment. We continue the pollination mechanism in higher plant in next video. So now we stop here.